Hello friends, my name is Amit Elani. Now today I am going to teach you, the topic is ring topology. We already discussed about the number of topologies earlier video. Now let's start with the ring topology. In ring topology, we have some story about the ring topology. Like we can I will tell you the exact scenario. In ring topology, there is a one station that is called as a monitor station. Monitor station just like a similar to the server, but this is a little bit different because there is a common node in which is selected in as a monitor. Monitor is responsibility to start a token frame because in ring topology, every station send a data whenever the token frame is received. This token frame is started with the monitor station. When first monitor station start the token frame and send our data to the next station or some other station, and at a time monitor send the data, at a time he will also send the token frame with this data. So there is a two possibility was there. There is a early token release or delay token release. Early token release means whenever station send the data, at a time station has to send the token frame with the data frame. So that is called as a early token release. And the delay token release is whenever the data sent by the station is received to the, or we can say received to another station, or it takes one complete round to the another station, then and receive another station, then he will send the token frame. That is called as a delay token release. Now the monitor station also monitored the token frame when station is some other station send the data. So at the time there is a possibility that station will be down. So there is a case that all the data frame will be circulated continuously infinitely. So monitor station is observed that which frames continuously circulating in the ring topology again. So it has a power that it will discard the packet whenever the station is down. Let's start with the ring topology. In the ring topology, a special frame called as a token is circulated in the ring. We already discussed that. Next one is, if station want to send the data to another station, then keep the token and send the data. So there is a possibility, there is a never possible at all collision will possible, because only one station has to transmit the data whenever a token is received. Now the next one is that every station has to receive token. So there is a possibility some time, that is a token holding time. So there is a when time taken by the station to hold a token. One more case is that in ring topology, only one direction will be sent to the packet or ring circulated. That is anti-clockwise or either clockwise. So generally in the every book, we always follow the clockwise direction. Right? One more thing that what happened when link is down. So there is a possibility link is down, or we can say link is breakage. So what happened then? The nearest station will send the one beacon frame in the reverse order that this link is down or this link is breakage. So nobody have to send the data from this to this. So it's the responsibility of the nearest station. So this is always follow the reliable concept. Now let's start with the deep concept in this topic. So we have to calculate here ring latency. What is ring latency? Ring latency is that a time taken by a bit to complete one rotation in the ring, means a one bit is traveled in the ring topology and complete one cycle. So how much time it is take, that is called as a ring latency, or you can say ring latency time. Now ring latency will be discussed with some other concept. First is one bit is travel. So we already discussed in the previous topic that in the flow control, that when token or frame, or you can say a bit is traveled in the ring or in the channel. So we have to calculate always calculate the ring propagation delay. So propagation delay means distance upon velocity. So ring ring latency is nothing equals to the propagation delay. Plus every station has takes some bit delay, because whenever I send one bit at a time B takes some bit, and there is some processing time, or we can say some bit delay. So here we can say is the bit delay will be the B. So in the every station there is a bit delay. So that is a 4 station. We are talking about the N station, which is the multiply with the N. Now the your ring latency will be the propagation time plus bit delay into N. So every station takes some bit delay time. So it will be calculated in the form of bits, or we can call we can also calculate with the form of seconds. So whenever in calculate with the form of second, so I can divide with the B. Here PT will be the distance upon time. Now I can write here the B is the bandwidth. When we are talking about the seconds, so the we have to divide with the this portion, we divide with the B. How it is possible? It is a distance upon velocity. Distance means the meter, velocity means meter per second. So your distance cancel, meter cancel. Now the in the denominator we have denominator is a second, so it will goes to the upside. So second plus bit into N by B. Bit again, then bandwidth will be always calculate the bits per second. So bit and bit cancel. Now the second plus second, so the total unit will be the SI unit is second. So there is a SI unit, we also discussed that there is a second. Now if we calculate the bit delay, we have to calculate the ring latency in the term of bits, because we already have a bit delay. So here we have to divide with the B. So now I can multiply with the bandwidth here with the propagation delay. Now distance upon velocity into bandwidth. Now we can calculate meter upon second, so that is the seconds. Second will be multiplied with the bits per second, so second is cancelled. Now the bit plus bits, so there is a whole unit will be the calculate the bits. So every time question will ask in the gate examination, sometimes ring latency calculate in the form of bits, or sometimes in the form of seconds. Now we have to calculate the efficiency. Before efficiency, we have to calculate the complete time, or we can say cycle time. Let's start in the calculate the total time or complete time. Total time or complete time for the token. Now, before I can discuss with the bits. So bits will be the anything. So now we can calculate with the token. But what about the token? Every token takes some time. That is, we already discussed that is a token holding time. Before that, it's a bits. It's a data bit. So we can calculate with the bits. Now we can calculate the token holding time, right? What happened? There is a total time is equals to PT, because of the circular time, that is a PT propagation time plus token holding time. Every station takes some time to hold the token, and there is an N station, so I can multiply with the N. So that is a simple as usual, that is a ring latency. Then the total is time is equals to PT plus total holding time into N. Now we have to calculate useful time. What about the useful time? Useful time is, we know that there is a frame or a data frame will travel in the complete ring. So we have to calculate the data length, or we can say number of packet of size. Before earlier, when our topic is flow control, we have already calculated with the useful time. So useful time is always calculated with the number of packet or length of the packet. So length of the packet is always calculated with the transmission time, because transmission time is nothing but a length upon bandwidth. So here every station sends some data, or every station sends some data packet. So the complete ring latency, there is a packets are traveled. So every station some data packet. So that is calculated with the transmission time, because every station had to send some data packet. So the transmission time is nothing but a bit will be the putting on the link that is called the length, putting on the link that is called as a transmission time. It is depend on the length upon bandwidth. Now the useful time will be the TT, right? Transmission time into every station, that is one. There is an N station, so that is N. So TT into N by total time will be the PT plus token holding time into N. So the whole formula is form in the we can say like in the form of A. So when we talk about simplified the formula, so we have a form, we have the variable that is A, is nothing but a PT upon TT. Now we can divide with the TT denominator. So here is a PT upon TT, now it will be the A, right? And TT here division in the second part. So TT open holding time into N upon TT. So there is no changes, right? But one more question arises in our mind, right? Means your mind, that what is token holding time? So we have two method here, token holding time calculated. First is early token release and the delay token release. So both will be vary on a token holding time. Now in the next video, I will tell you the token holding time, how we can calculate. Thank you.